Module 5, Exercise 1. We're going to do a length cover classification, and we're going to use points that are sampled from the map. You can do that in the interface, and I'll show that. So you can just put points there, and you see that above it will be put in a variable geometry. And the best way to sample this is using the high resolution satellite background image. And then after sampling, you can click the gear button. And there you can change the name of the feature. Let's call it in this case other class. And make it a feature collection. And the property is the field in the attribute table in a normal GIS. And then the value is the number of the class. So I've done that for these different classes. So there's urban. You can see here, land cover, 0, feature collection, bear, class 1, etc. I'm going to remove the other class, that was just an example. And make sure you have imported the ULB polygon from the assets, because we are going to use the boundary. And let's start writing the code for the classification. First I want to center the map at ULB. With a zoom level of 8. We're going to classify a Sentinel-2 image. So I'm just going to import the image collection. And I use there the snippet, copy it, paste it here. Let's visualize this. Define in a dictionary how we want to visualize this. Minimum value of 0. Maximum value of 3000. And I want a true color image, so I'm going to use bands 4, 3, and 2 of Sentinel. I want to filter the image collection. First on the cloud cover attribute. Remember, that's from the metadata, the cloudy pixel percentage. And we choose here again 30%. Then I want to apply the classification to the year 2020. So I'm going to give the date range here in the date filter from the 1st of January to 31st of December 2020. And of course, we want to use the boundary of our study area, so the ULB polygon and then the geometry of that. And we want to only use the bands that start with a B, because those are the ones we can use for the spectral signatures and not the other bands. If we look at the Sentinel image collection and we go to bands, we see that there are also quality bands with the Q, and we don't want to use those, so therefore we use only the ones with the B. We also want the best pixels, so we're going to use the median again, so we get the best pixels in the year, and also clipped to ULB. Let's have a look at this input image before we continue. So I'm going to edit map.addLayer, and then the composite. I'm using the RGB vis that we defined, and then call it image. Let's run this. That's our image. Now we're going to use the ground control points to create the sample for training the classifier. So create a variable, GCPs. And I need to merge all these points for the different classes into one feature collection. So I start with urban, I merge the bare soil in there, and then I merge water, and then the vegetation class. So those are the classes that we have imported in the beginning of our script by clicking those points. So now we need to get the values from the different bands at those points to create a spectral signature. And that will be our training data. So create a new variable, I call it training, and I use our composite. and then I use a function sample regions, and it can use the feature collection that we had to sample from the image. So I create a dictionary to provide the necessary input. So the collection that we're going to use as the sample points is GCPs. I'm going to look at the land cover property. Remember, that's then the attribute with the values of the classes. And the scale, because it will fit to the pixel size, is 10 meters, which is the highest resolution of Sentinel images. Now we can use that to train a classifier. Create a new variable called classifier, and I use there the classifier. And here you see the different classifiers, and I use there the smile random forest with a value of 50 trees. Then we can train that classifier with the information that we have. So the features come from training. The class property is again land cover. Our input properties, we use the composite and then the band names. And now we can classify the image by using the composite and then apply the classifier. And then we want to visualize the result, the classified map. And for the thematic classes, I define that with a dictionary here. The minimum class value is 0, the maximum is 3, and then we use a palette. So the zeros are urban, so I want that in gray. One is bear, let's make that brown. Then water is blue, and vegetation green. So choose intuitive colors that people understand when they look at the map. Then we can use map add layer to add it to the canvas. Use classified and then class vis for the visualization properties. And I call it 2020, the year of the classification. Let's run it. There's the composite, and there's our classification appearing. Now for the assignment, try this on your own study area if possible. Try to sample nice classes from the high resolution satellite image. And then submit the link to the classification.